Hello friends, I hope you like my 12th video that is about installation qualification. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the operational qualification for computerized system. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality, so please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standard and practices. So in this slide, we will discuss about the operational qualification for computerized system. So operational qualification assures the procured hardware and software components are operates as intended within its operating range. So for example, in HPLC instrument, there is a column oven and let's say this column oven has the operating range, for example, 10 to 50 degree, right? Then the software and hardware must configured in such a way that when you give the command from the software below or above this operating range, then it should be restricted and provide an error message. So when you give the command in between this operating range and software and hardware act, it is like that and take the command and execute the process. So this is just an example what system must operate with this range only, right? So I hope you understand. So operational tests shall be designed to challenge and demonstrate the system ability to operate in accordance with the functional specification. So whatever the privileges and function are available with the software, we need to challenge. And also in the operational qualification test related to 21 CFR part 11 or EU Annex 11 need to be perform, right? So now what is operational qualification protocol, right? So the operational qualification protocol is a collection of test cases used to verify the proper functioning of a system. So as discussed in previous slide that we need to perform the challenges related to overall functionality of system. So in the qualification protocol, we need to mention about the such tests, right? So operation qualification protocol should be approved before the protocol execution. So operation qualification protocol should be approved by the quality, then only test can be performed. And also, you know, the installation qualification must be executed and approved prior to start the operation qualification, right? So the executed protocol should be signed by the tester and reviewed by the system owner and approved by the quality. So now in this slide, we will discuss what should cover in the operational qualification protocol, right? So the following test may include but not limited to. So first one is the verification of functionality requirement. So whatever the function available with the software, we need to verify. For example, in chromatographic data system, you need to prepare some instrument method, processing method, sequences, and after completion of sequence, we need to process the chromatogram. So such things we need to verify, right? Second one is the verification of regulatory requirement. So whatever the requirement with respect to the 21 CFR part 11 and EU Annex 11, we need to verify, right? Third one is the verification of report requirement. So in this, we need to verify the system can be able to generate a non-editable report. The report generated from that system, that should be in a non-editable kind of things, right? So and that report can have the integrity of data that is transferred from the raw data to some report format, and also have the that report also have the identification number from which system the data has been generated. You know, the like system ID and product related details, and also the identification of operator that who has performed that activity. So such things we need to verify related to report. So fourth one is the verification of backup and restoration. So whatever the data generated from that system during the routine activity, so all the data backup should be done on daily basis, right? And also we need to verify the backed up data for its integrity, that is registration of data. So backup and registration we need to perform, we need to challenge in the OQ, right? Fifth one is the verification of user roles and privileges. So in this, we need to verify the all the privileges available with the system with respect to the different user group. So with respect to the different user group, all the privileges we need to verify into this, right? Sixth one is the verification of accuracy of audit trial. So in this, we need to verify the audit trial integrity, the audit trial is capturing all the processes while performing the activity, that is who has performed that activity and when it was performed and why it is performed. So such kind of things with respect to the audit trial we need to perform. So friends, in this slide we will discuss about the practical approach to write an operational qualification test script. So the first test script for the verification of system security. So in the step of OQ test script, following details we need to mention for the verification, but not limited to. So here I am explaining the general guideline for operational qualification test script, that what we need to consider into the operational qualification during writing a test script, right? So first one is verification of new user creation. So in this, we need to create different type of user as per the assigned privilege group, for example administrator group, operator, reviewer or manager group, right? Next is verification of duplicate user creation. So in this, we need to create a duplicate user, that is the user which is already created into the system, to verify that the system is not allowed to create the duplicate user, right? So next is verification of password reset option. So in this, we need to check for the password reset option availability and system allowed to reset the password as and when required. Next is verification of password change during the first login. So in this, we need to verify that system allowed to change the password whenever user login the first time into the system, right? So next is verification of modification for user group from one group to another group. So here we need to verify the system is allowed to change the user group from one group to another group. For example, currently it's the operator group, so from the operator group it can be allowed to change to the next group, for example river group. So such kind of things system can be allowed, right? So next is verification of enable and disable function for user. So in this, we need to verify the option availability for enable and disable, right? For example, when you want to disable any user when authorization is not required for that particular user, so you can able to disable that user, right? So next is verification of user deletion. So in this, we need to verify that system should not allow to delete any user from the user account. Now second is verification of system access control, that is verification of privileges for different user groups. So in this, we need to verify the privileges assigned to the different user group, right? So third is verification of data and audit trail protection. So here first is verification of data and audit trail storage location. So in this, we need to verify the where all the electronic data and audit trail will be saved, that is at which location in PC it will be saved, right? So and if the system is server based, then it will move to the some other location, and if the system is standalone, then it will be stored in the particular PC and backup of that data will be done, right? Next is verification of data readability. So in this, we need to verify that the data generated from that system, that should be in readable form and unambiguous, right? And also, if software is updated with the newer version, then migrated data should be supported by the new system, right? And it should be readable and integrity of data should be maintained. Next is verification of data and audit trial, backup and restoration. So in this we need to verify that system should allow to backup the data, restore the data, which include the audit trial also, right? So next is verification of audit trial for all activity. So in this we need to verify the generated audit trial capture the all executed activity, that is right from the login into the system to the logout of the system. For example, any user created or modified or any error or invalid attempts observed, etc. Next is verification of audit trial for 3 W's, right? That is called who, when and what. That means who has performed the activity, when it was performed, the activity with respect to the date and time, and what kind of activity performed, like any method creation or parameter modification, etc. So the such things we need to verify, right? Next is verification of disabled option for electronic data and audit trial. So in this we need to verify that there should not be any option to disable the generate the electronic report and audit trial, right? So next is verification of electronic data and audit trial modification. So in this we need to verify that the data and audit trial generated from the system, they should not be editable, right? So next is verification of deletion option. So in this we need to verify that the data or audit trail generated from that system, that should not be deleted. That is, no one can able to delete any data or audit trail, right? Next is verification of abort or reset option for ongoing activity. So in this we need to verify that if any system is in running condition, then there should not be any option to stop or reset the ongoing activity, right? If it is there, then data should be generated and audit trial should also capture the all activity. Next is verification of network failure protection mode. So this is applicable for the server based system. So in this, if network connection lost, then data shall be stored in the local disk, and after resuming the network, data shall be transferred to the server. So such thing we need to perform. So fourth is verification of system operational and accuracy check. So in this, first is verification of valid data acceptance in the system. So here we need to verify that the system must accept the valid data only within their acceptance limit. Next is verification of instrument equipment identification during the collection of data. So here we need to verify that the system captured the instrument equipment identification details during the collection of raw data, and this should also be reflected in the electronic report data. Next is verification of data alteration. So while transferring one to another form, so when the data generated into the system and transferring it to the report, then the data should be the same, right? That is, there should not be any data change while transferring the raw data to the report, right? So fifth is verification of system authorization check. So in this, first is verification of login with invalid user and valid password. So here we need to verify that the system does not allow the authorization when any invalid or valid password entered, right? Next is verification of login with valid user and invalid password. So here we need to verify that the system does not allow the authorization when any valid user and invalid password entered. Next is verification of login with invalid user and invalid password. So here we need to verify that the system does not allow the authorization when any invalid user and invalid password entered, right? So next is verification of login with valid user and valid password. So here we need to verify that the system allow the authorization when any valid user and valid password entered, right? Next is verification of option to change the password. So here we need to verify the availability of option for password change as and when required. Next is verification of password complexity. So here we need to verify that the system has the password complexity feature, right? So that is, password must contains the combination of password length, alphanumeric character, some special character, etc. Next is verification of lockout time. So here we need to verify that the system has the lockout feature, that is, after keeping the system idle for long, it should be automatically locked, right? So sixth is verification of electronic signature authorization, right? So in this, first is verification of procedure availability for electronic signature accountability. So here we need to verify that procedure should be available for the accountability of electronic signature. Next is verification of electronic signature certification submission to FDA, right? So here the electronic signature submission should be submitted to the FDA, which is stating the intent of using the electronic signature. Next is verification of electronic signature at report. So here we need to verify that the electronic signature should appear in the electronic report, that is, who has performed the activity, who has reviewed the data, and who has approved the data. So such details should capture into the report. So seventh is verification of appropriate control over system by the policy and procedures, right? So here we need to verify the some required procedure availability with respect to the system for its operation. So first is verification of system operation SOP, right? Next is verification of user management and system administration procedure. Next is verification of procedure for deviation, change control, kappa, etc. Next is verification of procedure for quality risk management. Next is verification of procedure for personal training. Next is verification of procedure for business continuity plan, right? So friends, I have explained the operation qualification with respect to the computerized system validation. Whatever I have explained, that may be limited. However, there are many other requirements based on the system complexity, right? So friends, this is all about the operational qualification, and in the next video we will discuss about the performance qualification. I hope this video will help to better understand what is operational qualification for computerized system. Thank you.